instead of reading a chapter, I'm going to read the foreword from my book because it says a lot, answers a few questions. Then I'm going to digress a little on answering another question, and then we can get to just questions and answers. So this is the foreword from my book. And it starts out with, I will never write a James Dean book. I've said that many times over the years, and I was certain that I would not. I've had offers and many people urging me to do just that. I refused because I felt that my short but rich friendship with Jimmy Dean was personal. And as far as I was concerned, Jimmy and I continue to be the closest of friends in the last 57 years, now 62 years. There have been over 200 books written about James Dean since his tragic death, with varying mixtures of fact and fantasy, rumors, innuendo, and simply false content. I didn't want to join that parade. Having written the book, I now know I actually avoided writing it because that meant opening a part of my mind to something I'd locked away since 1955. It meant revisiting a very important part of my life and examining my feelings. You are now asking yourselves, why did I finally agree to write this book? And I will tell you. In October of 2011, I was an honoree in Monterey, California for a once-in-a-lifetime Porsche race car classic where classic Porsches were going to be celebrated, including six from the Porsche Museum in Germany and many more from private collections. It also occasioned over 3,000 Porsche owner drivers descending on Monterey, and the great grandson of Dr. Ferdy Porsche being there. I was one of a handful, as part of this celebration, of former race drivers who, to quote, made an important contribution to Porsche between the years 1950 and 65, and the five of us were placed in the Porsche Hall of Fame. At a reception for invited guests only at Clint Eastwood's spectacular Tahoma Golf Club, I sat next to another honoree at the first dinner, who had done her racing of Porsches on the East Coast. I had done mine primarily in California. This person was now a journalist, Denise McCluggage, who has passed on, but lived to see the book published. She said she was starting a publishing company that would offer card books in digital form, e-books. When the fact was revealed that James Dean had introduced me to Porsches and racing, Denise asked me, do you have a book? I told her of my resolve never to write one, and she proceeded to try and change my mind every day for the 4 days we were up there, talking in terms of simply telling my own story, my friendship with James Dean, all the things that happened, all the things we did together, our conversations and feelings, and all of the events that I shared. I would write a story, not about James Dean, but about Jimmy Dean and Lou Gladner. I would write only what I knew. Nothing would be added. My younger daughter, Leslie, who was with me in Monterey, urged me to do it, as did my daughter, Allison, when I told her about the idea. Everyone who knows me well is aware of my excellent memory. In addition, I have written a lot of notes over the years concerning conversations we had or events we experienced. And you're probably asking yourself, why write notes if you weren't going to write them? I did it so my daughters would have them. My girls have always wanted to know as much as possible about this very important period of my life. I did it for them. I haven't to hold this story whether it gets published or not. But if you are reading this, you know the outcome. I have said that this is not a book about James Dean, but a book about Jimmy Dean and Lou Brackett. A story about a very close friendship of 18 months that ended on September 30th, 1955. It is a story of a relationship between two young guys in 1950s Hollywood. Two young men from very different backgrounds and with different pursuits. One still living at home with his parents, and the other living on his own. One living with a strong traditional Jewish family structure, not Orthodox come kosher, except when grandma was visiting. And the other lost his beloved mother at the age of 9 and was sent on a train with his mother's body to his uncle and aunt Hortense and Marcus Winslow in Indiana. A 9-year-old with a familiar world suddenly gone and an upside down being thrust upon him. It is the story of a great but short relationship, and I will put the rumors to rest right now. A very straight friendship. Different people have tried to determine why our friendship became so close. Trying to see it through Jimmy's eyes. The late great filmmaker Robert Altman's first feature film, in conjunction with his then partner, writer-director George W. George, was Warner Brothers' The James Dean Story, in which I appeared and did the driving of the Porsche Spyder. Bob had come to his own conclusions about our friendship. One early morning, we were on our way to a fatal accident scene to film the reenactment. We stopped in Castaic for breakfast. And as we were waiting for our order, Bob turned to me and asked, "Why do you think Jimmy committed himself to the closest friendship he would ever allow himself to be part of?" The question didn't surprise me. Bob was always trying to find out as much as possible about the mystery that was James Dean. I will always remember my answer clearly. I said Jimmy knew he could trust me and was completely at ease and trusting in my company around the house and with my family. I want to skip here for a minute to another page which has Bob Altman's answer to that. He said, "You were his rock, his center. You were straight solid. We were the base that kept him centered when things were going crazy." There are no rumors in this book added to spice the book up, and no scenarios or conversations invented. Nor have I inserted myself into situations where I was not personally involved. As the detective used to say on the old television show Dragnet, "Just the facts, man." No names have been changed to protect the innocent. I offer you then the story of Jimmy and me, my side, of course, through all my feelings, thoughts, takes, and hindsight wisdom. From the events and conversations of 62 years ago.